Hello, today's video is on eras. An era is a large period of time. We've broken down how we're going to study world history into nine different eras to kind of focus on what was happening during world history in each of those eras. I've constructed a basic timeline here that will kind of show you where the eras happen. We're over here in 2012, right here. And hopefully you can get an idea of a basic timeline set up as well. I made this one in Prezi. The first era we'll be studying is the beginnings of human society, everything before 4000 BCE. So that would be everything before humans really started becoming a society and how they got started, what started them. From the second era, we'll be studying early civilizations and the emergence of pastoral people. That happens between 4000 BCE and 1000 BCE, so how those early civilizations got started. Era 3 happens between about 1000 BCE and 300 BCE. We'll be looking at the classical traditions, how some of the major religions spring up around there, and some of the big empires that come up. In Era 4, from about 300 BCE all the way to 1000 CE, we'll be looking at how trade has become a bigger deal and how different countries and different regions have started trading with them. Different empires have started trading with each other. So we'll be looking at in Era 4, expanding zones of exchange and encounter. In Era 5, from about 1000 to 500 CE, we'll be looking at intensified hemispheric interactions, which really means how different parts of the world, different sides of the world, begin to interact with each other. Then in Era 6, from about 1500 CE to around 1770, the late 1700s, we will be looking at the emergence of the first global age that starts with around the time when Columbus travels to North America and all of the interactions that happened there and everything up to around the early 1800s. In Era 7, we'll be looking at an age of revolutions that starts from like the US Revolution in the late 1700s. And goes all the way up to the early 1900s, looking at different revolutions going on in Europe as well. In Era 8, we'll be looking at a half century of crisis that will take us from 1900 to 1950 and cover World War I and World War II. And then for our ninth era, we will be studying the second half of the 20th century. So 20th century since 1945, so about the past 70 years. And we'll be looking at the promises and paradoxes. So some of the promises that people have made, and we are trying to make the world a better place and solve those crises from the early 20th century, and then some of the problems that come with that we're trying to solve. Here we are in the present, 2012. So hopefully that gives you a good idea of the timeline and just introduces you basically to the different eras that we will be looking at. You'll notice there's some larger ones, second era being a very large area that covers many thousands of years, and then we get into some smaller ones toward the end where they only cover about 50 years.